everyone. So the next episode of our Dark Souls 2 playthrough is a Pyro Samurai. Last episode, we got access to some new pyros to work with. We added Firestorm. We also swapped out the Soul Collecting Ring for more attunement slots. We also joined a Blood Covenant. Blood for the Blood God type of area. Well, I think, honestly, what's our current... That only increases the poise by 10. I don't know how useful that actually is in this game. We'll keep the Blood Covenant ring on for now. I just realized we're kind of lacking in the poison resistance department. So,
are you a traveler?
We'll probably go back to Julian and see if they sell anything like that.
An ore stone trader. I travel about collecting rare stones, which I sell to make my living. I never planned to visit this God's forsaken place. I just sort of ended up here. I must have just wandered in. But now that I'm here, I've been scouting around for rare bits. Oh, don't look at me like that. Many of these stones are quite useful. For instance, certain stones are used in smithing. Oh, now your ears prick up. Have extras if you can pay. This is my trade, after all.
Let's see what she sells. No more Titanite shards. Bonfire aesthetic.
I came here in search of rare stones, but the place is nothing like I was told. All this poison, you can't get very far inside. Don't just go haplessly wandering about. These stones may look, or some of them are used to smith weapons, and some of them are extremely rare. None of the differences are easily trying let. How is it that I ended up here? It's funny. I've searched every nook and cranny here. Perhaps we'll meet again.
I think she will move to Majula, which we'll check right now. Because like I said, we are going to try and invest in some poison resistance. Yep, there she is.
Meeting you here. Speak up if you need any. These stones, maybe. You know how they... Well, in the old lore, what was it? Since long, long ago, each like a great... Maybe that's why people don't... You see that black... Is he one of those... Hollow? He sort of looks like my father. He's a blacksmith too, you see. The poor man's... But... I was born in a land to the west, Bulgan. There are great, but for me, and so I set out. There are dangers, but for the life, it's as if I were drawn to these stones.
So that's heavily implied that she is the daughter of the blacksmith. So that's all I do now. Let's talk to her old friend, see if he says something about it. Let's see. Have you upgraded your shop at all?
Nope. Drat. You're worse than my reckless daughter. Don't spend your whole life in... You'll need souls. I know only of smithing. Don't waste your souls on use. My witless daughter, just as oblivious as she's always been. Well, at least stones, you might be some... Drat. Don't...
Let's see if she sells poison resistance stuff. Nope.
If you want so.
You're my only customer. We call not. It's just the lonely.
We got 16 of them. Could be better, could be worse. Is that when we're standing cells on the poison spreads? No. We'll just use life gems to counteract it. I will not be surprised if I die just forgetting about poison damage. Panic time. So apparently the skeletons can parry. Fire seed. Oh, we got fire seeds to burn. Although we're getting more souls than we have, so we'll explore the area, and when we're ready to move on to the area, we'll go back and buy some fire seeds. Hey! We've been looking for this guy.
Gavlan, what with Gavlan?
Let's see. Do we have anything new to sell? What are you selling this time? We're gonna get one of those. Hang on, let's do some math. How many are we gonna need? 1500, 17 of them. We need almost 26,000 souls to buy the rest of these. We won't be able to buy all of them, but we'll buy a good chunk of them. Almost by half of them.
Many. What? With Gavlan? Gavlan? You.
So he gave us his great axe. How does that look? Oh, look at this thing. It's so gaudy, I love it. Oh yeah, there's still the fact that we're almost dying here. Sorcerers really hurt, which is why if I can attack them out of their range, we're gonna do that. That way is blocked off, so I guess we go this way. Is this literally what's blocking it off? This. Crystal lizards. Right, let's get all the crystal lizards before we do anything else. Thank you. easier time if we just hit him with the bow. Last time. Alright. I think we'll explore over here first, because this the other way leads to where we need to go. And the rule of thumb in video games is you always go in the opposite direction right now. Oh. It's just the whole randomness isn't the best for PvE. Don't get me wrong, it's awesome for PvP. But we're not really a PvP class. We're going on a journey through the Dark Souls 2 story. Thought that was a secret door, but it's just death. Next time we go to Majulo, we need to use some of these stones. Death? Yeah, I think that's death. I want to test it with my cat's ring, but... Okay. I see, so we do gotta go take that shortcut back. I also gotta remember to talk to the cat to change our covenant. Because we're probably not gonna stay with the, blood god. I think I remember these guys hitting like a truck. Oh, okay. We gotta get him to destroy that one too. I remember right, fire is really useful here. We went like 21 minutes without dying. The instant we want to create some light, a skeleton shows up, and instead of healing, we try to kill him first. I'm gonna go against my own advice and use an effigy. Whenever you're exploring an area, I'll just go drop our things off with the crows now. But whenever you're exploring areas, my rule of thumb is to not, in either of the games, don't use an effigy, don't use humanity, don't use a, what do they call it in the third game, a cinder? Because a lot of times when you die is when you're exploring areas for the first time, seeing the ambushes happen, the angles and all that. So instead of, you know, dying, using another one to gain your human form, and then getting upset because you died exploring and you lose a human form, you just die in your non-human form and you don't lose a resource that's hard to farm. So this is kind of like the lottery for the game. Sometimes you get really good things, sometimes you don't. I think you can drop other things besides the obvious ones, but I don't have them rememorized, wow. Like that, I just randomly got the Demon's Great Hammer. And a Titanite Slab. Like, just giving them a random petrified something, I got this. We have a branch. Even though I complained earlier how we wasted a branch and it screwed up our pathing, we're gonna do it again. There we go. Okay, we one-shot these guys. Jump to his death, we take those. Another thing, if you look real close to these creatures, they're called Basilisk. Those giant eyeballs are not actually eyeballs. If you look right at the corner of their jaws, you'll see their actual eyes. A little interesting fact about them. They were that way in the first Dark Souls as well. See if we die to fall damage. Oh, I lived. Nessus Lock Shard. Nice. now that we've gotten past the beginning of the game, we have so much healing. Someone else. Hey, look. Another effigy whenever we're done with this area, but you know. What? The reason I've been burning effigies is to see if there are invasion spots. Hey, dropped a petrified something. Oh, they're a one-time thing. Got it. Oh, what the... Why is he leaving? He spent so many resources on him, why'd he leave? Right, we're gonna go back and try to trigger that again. Because we could have defeated him. To see if that, I keep calling them either ogres or cyclops. They can be called something completely different. Like, for some reason, like, hippo something is in my mind. Is what they're supposed to be called. Alright, let's see if he shows up. So the Cyclops things are gone.
You, give us food.
Petrified something.
Yes, you! Give us Saki!
White ring?
Yes.
If I remember, this makes us look like a summoned phantom. Yeah. Whoa. One of the benefits of that, because probably need your crash as well, let's point at that ring. When you get invaded, the person that's invading, if they're just trying to get their victory and leave, they're going to take down the summoner first. Because if the summoner dies, the phantom just disappears. Alright, there we go. This episode I was supposed to be just exploring the Harvest Valley, but got sidetracked. The nature of your being has changed. Oh shit! I completely forgot about this. So that's interesting. Like, all the complaints people have about the game, it is cool that they have respecing in the games, so exchanging in the game. So you literally could just make one character if you are smart with your resources. I think that's pretty cool. But as I said a few episodes ago, like, a lot of the changes I'm not a fan of. But I mean, hey, you're trying to reach out to a bigger audience, like, you gotta try making some changes to see if it's what brings people in. If you just keep doing the same thing, you're only gonna bring in the same people. Now that we're done with that sidetrack, we'll go back to Harvest Valley. Maybe Gavlan is here. Nope. Well, that's a shame. We'll just spend the points, level up, and head out there.
Is to see luck, however.
Oh yeah, we grabbed a shard too. We're not benefiting from strength right now, but I want to put points into strength now before I need it. Because we need 20 strength for the item, well, for the weapon that we're going to be going for. Okay, I think we still need to explore. Yeah, we still gotta explore this way. Because we need that big guy to destroy the other wall. Come on, big guy. Thank you. Design. Old Night Pike. Torch. Another silk stone. What does the pike look like? That's the winged spear. Oh. Might end up using it. It's probably a strength base though, isn't it? Oh yeah, it's big time strength based. I'm trying to find a pole arm that's dex based and that I like the looks of. That's the tricky part. Because we're going with the whole samurai theme. Right, we're gonna kill you and then get some light. That's a little underwhelming. I thought there was more to explore. Maybe this path is more to explore? I guess that's it for that area. Alright, first we'll... Ow! Trying to like track the fireball, but I don't see the origin point of it. Man, there's that guy way up there. No way it came from up there. Okay, it came from up there. The reason I'm doing this is because there's too many variables down there. There's crawling enemies, there's the poison, and there's the fireballs coming from the sky. We have Firestorm and some Pyromancy to help for like big groups of enemies. But the Firestorm is kind of random, so we don't want to just immediately rely on it. another Titanite slab. So, this is the reason why we bought all those mosses. Dragon Charm, don't know what that does. Oh, the washing pool! Some more strength. Ooh, that would give us a swipe. Maybe we will use the... What are our resources looking like right now? We have plenty of Titanite shards to do this. We can farm for large Titanite shards. Maybe we will switch to the washing pool. I know we picked up something. It was a dragon something. Is it this? Yeah, Dragon Charm. Cures boys and grave stores HP. Let's see, that's 18 strength. We're almost there. So we'll use the Uchi Katana until we get 18 strength and we'll switch to that. Oh yeah, we already triggered the ambush. Ow. Ow. Let's see. Yeah, the washing pole is probably going to be better for us. We'll attack slower, but we have more versatility attacks. Besides just slashes, we'll also have a stab. Oh, I'm going to regret this, but this looks jumpable. Hey, it's Lucatiel.
Still on the road. Sorry to have burdened you so. This is for you. I found my thought. My memories are fading. The curse is doing its work. I am frightened. If everything should fade. I had an older brother. He became the most decorated. I never even compared.
Oh. I never beat him. I'm going to assume Creighton is her brother.
But then, now I'm certain. If only someone, my brother must have soon I'm in. If only someone, my brother, soon I'm in.
I think we have a lot of lockstones, so might as well use them. See if there are any hidden walls in this area. Poison bite ring, I'm assuming is like the other game where it's poison resistance. So let's see, poison bite. Might as well use it. Oh wait, I gotta remember fire from above. Take care of this guy first. A lot of deaths in this area. Oh, it's the Sun Covenant. So this is how you become a Sun Bro. No way. Oh well, still good doing. Let's see. We got 10 minutes before an hour. I think we can get to the boss within that. Boss room right there, actually. I don't remember these traps. It must be added from the DLC. See, figured that'd be a mimic. Oh, it's still a trap though. There's a reason for dropping here. There we go. Now we know why. Before we take on the boss, we are going to fail at jumping here. It's like I know what I'm talking about. We're going to explore that area and then take on the boss. I think if we do it on one run, we can still get this video done in about an hour's length of time. Now, all the way back here, huh? Thank you. So I guess if you need Titanite shards, you go here to farm. Okay. Can I roll and make that? That's funny. I should be updating that MooBot thing. Give me a second. Bit of a hassle, but I can get it done. I keep forgetting I have fire seeds too that we need use to upgrade. These guys have no poise. Only 27 deaths away from the complete playthrough of the first Dark Souls. If that gives you guys an idea of how this has been going. An entire game, 67 deaths. We're maybe a third of the way into the game, and we're almost matching it. We just randomly get invaded. I wonder if it's just triggered after death or something. Alright, let's see if we can put on that ring before he dies. Does he resist poison? Yeah, free human effigy. Take those. Let me just go waste it real quick for him. Just to show how little that meant. We're gonna do this a little bit smarter. Oh, wow, that does no damage. Thank you. Come on. me the... Do we... Alright, yeah, we use him as a wall. We are geniuses. If it wasn't for all those deaths, we'd probably already have killed the boss by now. And we might die again. Cross with a plus 3. Is that really? I feel like I'm forgetting an area in this section. That's definitely not an NPC. Maybe it's further on. I remember there like being an area with a bunch of those poison bugs just in a room. But for all I know, they might have changed it. There, if we can kill this guy in 40 seconds, we'll keep to our word. I think there's really only one move you have to worry about with him. Just past an hour. Is all those deaths? I think Firestormer's bugged there. Let's try it again. Yeah, this is where we'll end today's episode. Sorry I got sidetracked for a little bit longer. Next episode, we'll be finishing this area that is called... Give me a minute. Earthen Peak, that's what it was called. Next episode, we'll finish Earthen Peak, and then it is on to Iron Keep. So thank you for watching. And we'll see you guys next time.